Hey guys, it's here. I do Andy review the Creo Dungeons & Dragons Lightning Cannon. So this is the box here. So you can see it's recommended for just Jason Croft and comes with 115 pieces and comes with two creons, which are the Orc Archer and also the Knight Archer. So yeah, this is set A67 Cree 7, and yeah, well, this is the back of the box here, and yeah, showing you like how you can play it, I guess, and also advertisement for the all the other sets and Master the Battle, and also here you also got this Master the Battle thing, and yeah, this is the bottom, but. Aside from that, that's it for the box. So this is the instruction manual here, and yeah, as you can see, it's actually pretty big for a set of this size, and yeah, it's all like just folded up inside the box, and as it is so small, but yeah, it's actually very interesting, the instructions, but you got this really nice artwork thing, and you got the Orc Archer, the Knight Archer, and the build, yeah, they're all just pretty basic, and the back here, so this is the final page of the build, and shows you, you can connect it to the other Creo Dungeons & Dragons set, and yeah, one of them is this Fortress Defense set, which is a bigger box set, and shows you got this challenge card, which I'll show you later. You got a parts list, and it's really hard to show with all this whole thing folding up and everything. And finally, the back, you have the advertisement for the rest of the same series, and yeah, but aside from that, that's it for the instructions. So the set also comes with this game rules paper tough thing, and yeah, just shows you how you can play the game, and yeah, well, also this set also comes with some cards. So you got these I guess Creon cards or character cards, I guess, and yeah, so you got the Orc Archer right here, and you also got the Knight Archer, and this is the back, and also comes with these challenge cards, they are called, and yeah, so you got this first one with this one, which you can hit the Knight Archer with only one attempt, and you can hit the Knight Archer behind this barrier tower thing with one attempt as well, and you can hit the barrier with one attempt, and yeah, this is the back, and comes with a Creo break just like all the other Creo sets, and yeah, looks nice, and something interesting here, so yeah, the sticker sheet comes with an extra sticker, which is this Creo sticker, and yeah, not sure what to do with it, but yeah, so that's it for all the side stuff and cards. So first off, this is the Orc Crossbowman, or the Orc Archer. I'm not really sure what the official name for this guy is, but yeah, so you can see he has this pretty cool crossbow mode here, and it's pretty similar actually to Legos, except that this thing has a handle, so yeah, but you can see he has this hood right here, which is pretty nice mode, and yeah, it is a little bit rubber, so yeah, that's great, and under here you can see his face, and the torso printing, you just have the Orc symbol right there, and yeah, you just have some strap, and the leg printing, you just have this you have that knee pad type thing, I'm not really sure what it is, but yeah, does also come with a base plate and no back torso printing, but yeah, so aside from that, that's it for the Orc Crossbowman. So the second crayon figure here is the Knight Archer. So yeah, you see he comes with his bow right here, and yeah, it is a very nice mode. And yeah, it's actually pretty accurate to the real thing. And yeah, so you see he got his knight helmet here, I guess. And yeah, it's a really great mode. And yeah, for some reason I can't remove it without removing the hit, but yeah. So you see it's, so you see this piece right here, it looks pretty great. You have all these detailing right here. Not sure if this is on purpose or just a molding problem, not sure. But yeah, so you see under there, you can see you got a this archer's face, and yeah, it's kind of this angry face, I guess. So yeah, he does have a quiver right here, and yeah, it looks very great. And you got all the arrow backs, I guess. And yeah, so the torso printing, you got the, I guess, the knight symbol, and he does also have a utility belt of some sorts. And yeah, so the leg printing, not sure what it is, but yeah, I guess it's probably like armor ring, I guess. And yeah, but aside from that, that's really it for the, so these are all the builds here. So let's start off with this Barret Tough thing. So yeah, you can see it's actually pretty similar to the one that came in the Orc's crossbow. And yeah, except that this one has spears at the front, and yeah, I guess it's to keep out enemies from, you know, charging in, I guess. And yeah, and it's also clipped on. So yeah, so you have all these wood, I guess, on here. And yeah, they are all just stickers, and you can move this thing around if you want to, but you can't move it that much. But yeah, this is kind of a barrier tough thing. And yeah, like here you have this Technic connector piece, and yeah, you just have all these Technic piece right here, so that you can connect it to the bigger set, which I showed you earlier. But yeah, and here you have a little bit a small spot to put the crayon figure if you remove him from his base plate. But yeah, if you want to play the game, then yeah, you probably shouldn't remove the figure from the base plate. But yeah, so aside from that, that's it for this knight's barrier, I guess. So this is the lightning cannon here itself. So this thing has a lot of features packed into it. So yeah, the front here, you can see you got this shield type thing or armor. But yeah, you just have the orc symbol, I guess. And yeah, they are printed, so that's definitely great. And yeah, so the wheels, they do roll pretty well, and you have these spears on the side as well. So you know, you can also you know, like kill enemies with it, I guess. But yeah, so these things actually, they have a kind of a small feature. So yeah, if you move this thing around, the spears will kind of move up and down, I guess. And if you move it really fast, they will just kind of like go up and down really quickly, I guess. But yeah, it's a nice feature. And you have all these pieces. You have this one piece right here pushing it. So yeah, but that's it for the wheels. So yeah, to the cannon part here. So you have all these stickers, which is all the armor and paneling, I guess. And yeah, so the cannon, it's actually pretty similar to the Lego's Technic cannon. I'm not sure which one fires further, but yeah, so this thing, it's on this Technic piece, so you can, you know, kind of move it. And yeah, you can just fire it. You can fire it by pressing this button, and it fires really hard. And you can hear the spring inside, and there's actually an extra of one of these. Yeah, comes with two in the set, in case you you lost one, and yeah. So the back, you have these things right here to kind of block it, I guess. And yeah, so here you have these words or symbols. I'm not sure what they are, but they are a sticker piece and they are there. So yeah, and you also have these pieces, which are for kind of like angling the cannon to make it into kind of firing position, I guess. So yeah, if you put it like this, it fires really far, like, yeah, it's crazy far, and yeah, it's pretty much like a straight up I guess a blaster, I guess. And yeah, but you do have to angle it like this, and yeah, but the good thing that here, good thing here is that it fires really far, so that's great. But yeah, so aside from that, that's it. So overall conclusion of this set, so how do I think of it? Well, the Creon figures here, I think they're definitely great. I'm not interested in them, but yeah, they do look nice. You have very nice modes for them, especially the bow and the quiver. And yeah, like, I think they are, all the pieces here, they are definitely great. Yeah, I'm not really into the figure itself, but yeah, I think the figure is pretty good, actually. And yeah, so the barrier part here, yeah, it's a pretty good side build, actually. It looks nice, and yeah, it's great that you can connect it to the bigger set if you have it, but if you don't, then yeah, I guess you can connect it to the smaller sets if you have the smaller sets. And yeah, so the cannon itself here, I mean, the build is actually pretty good. And yeah, I do like the feature of the spear thing moving up and down. Yeah, I think that's pretty cool. And yeah, like, this thing looks pretty good. And yeah, so the cannon fires really nicely, and yeah, it fires really far. So yeah, that's the thing. I'm not sure how it compares to the Lego Technic cannon piece, but yeah, I think the cannon here is definitely the best part about the set. And yeah, so overall, I recommend you getting this set. It's definitely worth your money, and yeah, you do get some really nice stuff out of it. So yeah, overall, I recommend you getting this set. Links for the set down in the description box below, along with all my social media pages down in the description. So if you like my channel, make sure to subscribe right here and watch more videos right here. So that's it for the video. Thanks for watching.